I want to show everyone this thing that it kind of went around. It was a memo that you sent to your staff, and it kind of made the rounds. I don't know how it got public, but it's unbelievable. It says, "To my wonderful staff, I want to take a moment and make something clear to everyone. I do not expect nor do I want any of you to miss or sacrifice important family obligations for work. Family obligations include, but are not limited to, family birthdays, anniversaries, weddings, any religious ceremonies such as first communions and bar mitzvahs, graduations, times of need such as illness or loss in the family. This is very important to me. In fact, I will go so far as to say that if I find out that you are working with me while missing important family responsibilities, it will disappoint me greatly. This has been an unwritten rule since my days in the Senate. Thank you all for your hard work. Sincerely, Joe." That is one of the best things I've ever read, and I loved it.
When I first got to the Senate, I got elected when I was 29, and before I turned 30, or just after I turned 30, I was down hiring staff. My wife and daughter were killed in an automobile accident, and my two boys were really badly injured. And I thought I was a decent father before then, but you realize that, in my generation, it was about quality time instead of quantity time. There's no such thing as quality time. Every important thing your child will say to you will be off script, as they say, will be at a time when you don't expect it. And kids can hold an idea for maybe 12, 14 hours, but after that, it's gone, man. You lose it. And this idea of the way we all rationalize, you know, I have to take the red egg at home for a birthday, but, you know, it really doesn't matter that much to my wife for a birthday. Or, you know, if I just make this business trip, I'll miss his last football game, but, you know, he'll understand. That's just a bunch of malarkey. It's just not true. It's not true. And I don't want anybody in my staff feeling an obligation to do something for me when there's something that matters in their family. And there's nothing noble about it. I do it. You know, when I ran a second time, I was, I had missed 14% of the votes the first time. And I ran against a good guy, and he had a very effective ad. He said, "Would you hire someone who missed 14 days out of every 100 days? They work for you." And I never missed a vote that made that was any decisive. They were procedural votes. And I went on the air, and I said, "Look, if you elect me again, and I have a choice between a procedural vote or going to my kid's parent-teacher meeting, I'm going to the parent-teacher meeting." And if I could hold myself to that, well, by the way, it's a lot easier for me because I had a million employers. You know what I mean? No, I really mean it. It's harder when you have a boss that. So I felt if I could do that, I should not hold my staff to any different standard. And by the way, I get more productivity out of my staff than people get who, are demanding them punch a clock.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I've said to my staff, I love this idea if it doesn't interfere with work. I think. Figure it out. Well, we can talk. You. Don't even think about it. Roman, yeah. The cue card guy's already leaving right now. Hey, Roman, nothing's happening this late at night, okay? No ball games are on right now.
Yeah. Anyway.
I want to tell you, I thought it was a great thing and a great message, and it just does make you think. I have two daughters, and I think about it all the time. I go, I just wish that I could
hold
just...
Hold them tight, man. It goes...
Yeah.
It goes very quickly.